Amen. John chapter number 11, family. Y'all ready? Amen. John chapter number 11. Amen. John chapter number 11. All right, John chapter number 11. If you're there, say amen. Amen. All right, let's do our smile next side. Turn to the person to your left, to your right. Show them your 32s, your 22s, your 12s, your 2s, whatever you have left to work with. Everybody in the house ought to be smiling. Let's hold our Bibles up and let's do our confession. Come on, stream alive, get them up. This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I am.
I am.
What it says I am.
What it says I am.
I can do.
I can do.
What it says I can do.
What it says I can do.
I can have.
I can have.
What it says I can have.
What it says I can have.
I am a believer.
I am a believer.
And not a doubter.
And not a doubter.
I am a doer.
I am a doer.
Not just a hero.
Not just a hero.
I believe the word.
I believe the word.
From Genesis.
From Genesis.
Through Revelation.
So let God be true,
every man,
a woman,
a liar,
in Jesus' name,
amen. In John chapter number 11, verse number 39, Jesus said, take away the stone. Martha, the sister of him who was dead, said to him, Lord, by this time there is a stench, there's a bad odor, for he has been dead 4 days. And Jesus said to her, did I not say to you, that if you will believe, you will see the what, family? The glory of God. So I've been teaching a series the last few weeks about, didn't I tell you? Oh, I told you. And I told you the purpose of this teaching was, put the objective there, to bring you to a place of being fully persuaded. To being what? Abraham, we're going to talk about this. I'm going to finish today, this series here. The Bible said Abraham was fully persuaded, and we're going to find out why Abraham was fully persuaded. Go to Mark chapter number 16. You have to always know that God confirms his words with signs following. He always confirmed his word with what, family? Signs following. So if God give you a word, signs going to follow that word. And that we know from the scripture, the Bible said, let everything be established by two or three witnesses. How you know you got a word from God? Signs going to follow it. How you know you're pregnant? We going to know. A few months, something going to stick out. Amen. Something going to stick out. Amen, amen. Signs always follow the word. We know the word is the seed. In Luke chapter 8, verse number 11, he said the seed is the word of God. See, if you're pregnant, pretty soon you're going to be showing. Amen, amen, amen. God always confirmed his word with signs following. In Mark chapter number 16, verse number 20, if you're there, say amen. And they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the what? Word. Look, everybody, look at me. God always going to confirm his word. See, he going to confirm his word, confirming the word through a company sign or through signs that follow. Go to Acts chapter number 2. Let's get some stories on this. Let's get some examples on this. Watch what Jesus. You know, Jesus was the word. Acts chapter number 2, verse 22. Acts 22, I want you to put it up there in the contemporary English version. Okay, Acts 2:22, if you're there, say amen. Watch this here, family. God always confirms his word with signs following. So when we look in Acts chapter number 2, verse 22, it says, men of Israel, hear these words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested approved by God to you. How? By miracles, wonders, and signs which God did through him in your midst. So the Bible says God proved that he sent Jesus by doing what? Miracles, wonders, and what? Now, everybody look at me, family. How many of y'all know that ain't changed today? See, if Jesus said the only reason you believe me because you see the miracles, you see the signs, you see the wonders, they're not going to believe you either unless they see the signs, the wonders, and the miracles. God always confirmed his words through signs followed. So when I look at the contemporary English verse, it said, now listen to what I have to say about Jesus from Nazareth. God proved he sent Jesus to you by having him to work what? Miracles, wonders, and signs. Look what the Living Translation, New Living Translation said. God, people of Israel, listen. God publicly endorsed Jesus of Nazareth, by doing powerful miracles, wonders, and signs through him. Let me tell you something, family. That's what I'm telling you. When you fully persuaded and you believe God, the same thing was on Jesus' life is on your life. The same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, guess where it is? Somebody say, in me.
Amen.
See, the Bible said, watch this here. He publicly endorsed Jesus. See, when you fully persuaded, something going to happen in your life. See, something going to happen in your life. Go to 1 Kings chapter 18. All throughout the scripture, we see when people believe God, see, he confirmed his words with signs following. 1 Kings chapter number what? 18. 1 Kings chapter number 18. Watch this here, family. The prophet Elijah. 1 Kings chapter number 18. 1 Kings chapter number 18. Now watch this here. Watch this here, family. Watch this here. If you're there, say amen. Look at verse number 1. I'm in 1 Kings 18, 1. Watch this here, family. It said, and it came to pass at the many days. Somebody say many days. That the word of the Lord came to Elijah in the third year, saying to him, go, present yourself to Ahab, and I will send rain on the land. Now, it hadn't rained for 3.5 years. Can you imagine that? But now, he got a word from God. So God always confirmed his words through signs following. So 3.5 years before this, the prophet told the king, said, it ain't going to rain unless it come from my word. He told the king that. The king had power to cut your head off. See, but the prophet, he's the messenger. He have to say exactly what God tells him. So now God said, now go present yourself to Ahab, the king, because he had just told him in chapter 17, it's not going to be in the rain until I speak it. Now God then dropped the word to Elijah saying, now go present yourself. 3.5 years later, the rain is coming. So Elijah go present himself to Ahab. Now what happened? The children of Israel had turned from God, and they had Jezebel, wicked Jezebel. Now she had brought the prophets of Baal in there, and now they worship in Baal. Oh, how we easily forget what God has done for us. Amen. So easily forget. So now we're talking about God confirming his word through signs following. Let's pick it up in verse number 21. Pick it up in verse number 21. If you're there, say amen. I'm in 1 Kings 18, 21. Are you there? And Elijah came to all the people and said, how long will you falter between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal, follow him. But the people answered him not a word. Then Elijah said to the people, I long and left as a prophet of the Lord. But Baal prophets are 450 men. Therefore, let them give us 2 bulls and let them choose 1 bull for themselves, cut it in pieces, lay it on the wood and put no fire under it. And I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood and put no fire under it. And you should call on the name of your God and I will call on the name of the Lord. And the Lord, what's here? And the God who answered by what?
Fire.
He is God. So all the people answered and said, it is well spoken. Let me tell you something, family. Your God always going to answer by fire. Remember, if it was a word from God, he's always going to confirm his words with signs following. Now, let's pick it up. So, you know, the prophet of Baal went first. The Bible said they set everything up. They prayed. They cried. They cut themselves. They went to the bathroom. Nothing happened. See, let me tell you something, family. That's what I'm saying. You got to be fully persuaded. That's why the word of God says in Matthew chapter number 6, verse 24, he said, you can't serve 2 gods. You can't serve 2 masters. You're going to love one and hate the other. You're going to be loyal to one and despise. See, we haven't chosen. See, for most part, God is our Savior, but he's not our Lord. When God is Lord over your life, he's going to answer by fire, baby. I promise you he will. So So they cried out from noon to that evening. Finally, Elijah said, enough of this. Now, y'all stand back. Let's see what happened. Because he got a word from God. And when you get a word from God, signs are supposed to follow. Now, watch this here, family. Let's pick it up in verse 36. Now, I'm in 1 Kings 18:36. Y'all ready? Watch this here. And it came to pass at the time of the offering of the evening sacrifice, Elijah the prophet came near and said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day. Somebody say this day. This day. That you are God in Israel, and I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your what? Word. Now everybody look at me. We know that the title of the message is, watch this here, didn't I tell you? But the subtitle is, I told you. See, anytime, somebody say anytime. Anytime God gives you a word, he wants you to go public with it.
Yes, that's right.
See, you got to go public with what God tells you. So when it comes to pass, you tell people, you say, Harriet, yeah, you told me. Brother John, you told me. See, that's what I said. See, you told, why? Because you got a word from God. When God spoke to me, this April be 17 years, there ought to be some signs following.
All right.
Amen. See, watch this here. God, you told me. So he said, he said, Lord God of Abraham, Isaac, verse 36, let it be known, somebody say this day, that you are God in Israel, and I am your servant, that I have done all these things at your word. In other words, I ain't make this stuff up. Hear me, O Lord. Hear me, that these people may know that you are the Lord God and that you have turned their hearts, watch this here, back to you again. Then the fire what? Well, watch it. Then the fire of the Lord fell. Everybody look at me. Let me tell you why God's going to do wonders, signs, wonders, and miracles in you. So he can turn people's hearts back to him.
Right.
Now, they already born again. But when somebody see a miracle, you can't tell me if we see folk get up out of wheelchair, we see the blind see, the mute speak, the deaf hear. You can't tell me we won't be packed up in here next week. Because folks are seeking the miraculous. See, that's why somebody say me. God will do it in you. He's just looking for somebody to say, Lord, I believe you. See, why? Because he wants people to see. See, a lot of people, let me tell you something, family, they ain't never seen a miracle. Being, if you're born again, that's a miracle. Ask Nicodemus. See, I know I'm a miracle. Every week you come, you looking at a miracle. Praise the Lord. See, why? God want to turn people's hearts back to him. Now, watch this here, family. Watch this here. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt sacrifice. In the wood and the stones and the dust, and it licked up the water that was in the trench. Normally, water put out fire, but fire put out water. You know your God is God. When the fire department show up, they show up with what? Water to put out what?
Fire.
Your God show up with fire to put out
water.
You better recognize who's with you. You better recognize that the Lord is on your side. You better recognize if God be for you, baby, who was against you?
All right.
Who's on the Lord's side up in here?
Yeah.
Now watch this here, family. Watch this here. Verse 38. Now when all the people saw it, somebody give me a definition of all. When all the people saw this, the signs, the wonder, the miracle that was done, they fell on their faces and they said, the Lord, he is who? The Lord, he is who?
God.
That's what he always going to confirm his words with. John chapter number 10. Now, that was introduction. Let's get it on. So that was introduction. Let's get it popping up in here now. Come on, family. No, you got to recognize. You got to be fully persuaded. Elijah was fully persuaded that what God promised him, he was able to perform. Are you fully persuaded? See, we're going to get to that. Amen, amen, amen. John chapter number what, family? John chapter number 10. Look at verse 37. Amen. God always confirmed his word with signs following. I'm in John 10:37. If you're there, say amen. What's it? If I do not do, this is what Jesus said to them. If I do not do the works of my Father, don't believe me. Everybody look at me, family. Raise your hand if you're going to work tomorrow. Raise your hand if you're going to work tomorrow. Okay, put your hand down. Raise your hand if you're going to work this week. Okay, raise your hand if you're going to work this month. The rest of you lay the jokers. No, I'm just teasing. When you're on your job, you should be telling people during lunch breaks, during your 15-minute break, they should see some kind of form of God in your life. See, when he said right here, he said, if I do not do the works of my Father, don't believe me. Let me tell you something. This is what I'm telling you. You can talk about Jesus all you want to in your cubicle. They ain't going to believe you unless they see some works. Unless you done laid hands on them and somebody got healed. Everybody, they're going to be lined up at your cubicle. Said, will you lay hands? They ain't going to believe you unless they see the works. If they didn't believe Jesus, they ain't going to believe you. See, we keep telling, I know we got the bumper sticker. It's the fish, the sign of the, we got the fish, honk if you love Jesus. We got all that paraphernalia in our car. They ain't going to believe you, me either, unless they see the miracle. See, now look what he said right here. If I do not do the works of my Father, do not believe me. But if I do, though you do not believe me, believe the works. That you may know, somebody say no. Know and believe that the Father is in me, that I am in him. God always going to confirm his words with signs following. Now, let's talk about unbelief. Let's look at how God sees things with unbelief. Go to Romans chapter 15, family. Let's look at how God sees unbelief now. Come on. Romans chapter number what? Go to Romans chapter number 15. All right. Watch this. Let's talk about unbelief. Unbelief is the opposite of believing. Now, I want for you to see something. I want for you to see what God's mindset about unbelief. Romans 15:4. I can quote it, but I want to go to script. We're going to keep it moving. Romans 15:4. If you're there, say amen. He said, whatever thing was written before, they was written for our what, family? Learning. That we through patience and comfort of the scripture might have what? Might have what? Now, let's see how God look at unbelief. Watch it. See, now, go to Proverbs chapter 16. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. Amen. We should hate what God hates. Amen. Amen. We should hate what? God hates. That's what you should hate. And you should love what he loves. You should hate what he hates. And you should love what he... Okay, Proverbs chapter 16, verse 6. Proverbs 6, verse 16. Proverbs chapter number 6. When you get home, read 16:6. Something is in there for you. But right now, we at Proverbs 6:16. Proverbs chapter number 6, verse 16. If you're there, say amen. Look what it says, family. These six things the Lord what, family?
Hate.
These six things the Lord what?
Hate.
He hate pride, a lying tongue. We don't want to read about it. I just want to show you that it's some things God what? Hates. And whatever God hates, we should what?
Hate.
And whatever God loves, we should what? So we're going to look at God's disposition against unbelief. So go to 1 Corinthians chapter number 10. 1 Corinthians chapter number 10. Stay with me, streaming live. Amen. Amen. Stay with me. 1 Corinthians chapter number 10. Verse number 1. 1 Corinthians chapter number 10. Amen. God, so we should hate what God hates. We're going to look at God's disposition, his attitude, his temperament against unbelief. Family, let me tell you something. What I told you this lesson is to bring you to a place to being fully persuaded that what God promised you, he's able to perform. I'm telling you right now, before we start reading the scripture, that God hates unbelief. Why wouldn't you believe him? Why wouldn't you believe him? You understand what I'm saying? Just like we've been feeding TJ for 15 years. He come in today. Are we going to have some food today? I pray for him. That joke in the eight, he ain't never missed a meal. I'm talking about three or four a day. And then he come in and tell my dad that we going to have, for real? I can see if he missed a week or two. You know what I'm saying? But he ain't, somebody say never. He hates unbelief. Is there something in your life that you hate? That's something when you hear it, you're like, it aggravates you. God hates unbelief. So we pick it up in 1 Corinthians chapter number 10, verse number 1. If you're there, say amen. Moreover, brethren, I do not want you to be unaware or ignorant that all of our father was under the cloud, all passed through the sea. All were baptized into Moses, the cloud, and into the sea. And all ate the same spiritual food. All drank the same spiritual drink. For they drank of that spiritual rock and followed them, and that rock was Christ. But with most of them, what's it? But with most of them, listen, streaming live, but with most of them, God was not what, family? And we know without faith, it is impossible to please him. It said, but with most of them, God would not please with them. Watch here. But with most of them, God was not well pleased, for their body was scattered in the wilderness. Now these things became our example, to the intent that we should not lust after evil things, as they also lusted. And do not become idolaters. And were some of them, as it is written, the people sat down to eat, to drink, and rose up to pray. Nor let us commit sexual immorality, as some of them did. And in one day, 23,000 fell. If some folks start falling dead, I bet you'll believe. But we're under the grace dispensation right now. Watch this here. Nor let us tempt Christ. Watch this here, family. The word tempt means test. Don't let us test Christ. As some of them also tested, and were destroyed by the serpent. Nor complain, as some of them also complained, and were destroyed by the destroyer. Now all these things happened to them as an example, and they was written for our admonition, for our instruction, upon whom the ends of the earth have come upon. Now who is he talking about? He's talking about the children of Israel. The Bible said when they was in the wilderness, when God wanted to bring them in, they had unbelief. And the Bible says for 40 years, God let everybody 20 years and above die off because of unbelief. See, God hates. He said, now watch this here. Look at verse number 6. He said, now these things became our what? Example. See, verse 11. Now all these things happened to them as our. Remember, part of my teaching was examine yourself. Remember that teaching? Test yourself to make sure you are in the faith. See, he said, let me tell you something, family. He said, if they didn't get away with it, you're not going to get away with it. See, I want for you to see something. Where I want to go next. Let me see where I want to go next. Let's go to Romans chapter number 11. Romans chapter number 11. Hey, man, if they didn't get away with it, you don't get away with it either. Romans chapter number, you got to be fully persuaded that what God promised you, he's able to promise. Let me ask you a question. Let me ask you why you turn to Romans chapter 11. Why are you not fully persuaded? Hadn't God done enough? Think about what I just said. Hadn't God done enough to let you know he's the real deal, Holyfield? Hadn't God done enough, streaming live? Hadn't God done enough? I just like Linda and I have been married since 1992. February the 15th to be 25 years. And she's still coming to me and do you still love me? Hold on, baby girl. Bye right now. 25. I ain't got time to be playing with you. You ought to know baby boy love you by now. Come on, family. Are you still love me? Are you still going to be with me? How many of y'all know that'll wear you down? I wake up in the morning, I love you. But see, we've been together 25. Let me tell you something, family. What did God say? He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. See, he said, God, all throughout the script, he is showing us, I'm with you. I'm with you forever. Hadn't God done enough for you to be fully persuaded? What's the problem? What's the problem? See, what's the problem? Amen. If anybody knows, from now on, that man loves that woman. He don't love, he loveth that woman. Praise the Lord. But see, watch this here, family. In Romans chapter number 11, let me say I want to pick it up here. Romans 11, let's pick it up in verse 20. Romans 11, 20. God hates unbelief. You know, what is his temperament? He hates it. Verse 20. Well said. Because of what?
Unbelief.
They were what?
Broken off.
They were broke. Let me tell you something, family. Because of unbelief, they were broken off. See, he said, because of unbelief, they were broken off, and you stand by
faith.
Do not be haughty. Do not be arrogant, but fear. For if God did not spare the natural branches, the Israel, children of Israel, he may not do what? Spare you either. Therefore, consider the goodness, the severity, the word severity means the sternness of the harshness of God on those who fail. Remember 23,000 fail? They didn't go into the promised land because they didn't believe. Watch this here, family. But towards you, goodness. Watch this. If you continue in goodness, otherwise, you also will be what, family? And watch it. And they also, if they do not continue in unbelief, will be grafted in, for God is able to graft them in. Somebody say again. The Bible said they was broken off. They was cut off for one reason. Unbelief. He's saying there's no reason for you not to believe me. There's no reason for you not to believe me. Hebrews chapter number 3. Hebrews chapter number what? Hebrews chapter number 3. See, God hates unbelief. He called unbelief evil, man. It's evil not to believe him. Amen. Let me tell you something, family. Hebrews chapter number 3. I'm going to make a statement. Hebrews chapter number what? 3. Now watch this here, family. How many times when people don't believe you, you have an attitude? And how many, don't have to raise your hand, how many times you done lied? Everybody here will be saying, amen. Even Pastor Terry done lied. Let me tell you something, family. Let me say, and he's not a man that he should lie. No, the Son of Man should pick. If he said it, he going to do it. If he spoke it, he going to bring it to pass. You don't like when people don't believe you. Come on. You don't like when people don't believe you. And how many times we didn't tell the truth? And somebody say never. He never lied. See, he never lied. That's why he said unbelief is evil to him. God get an attitude when he sees unbelief. And Hebrews chapter number what? Hebrews chapter number 3. Let's pick it up in verse number 12. If you're there, say amen. Hebrews 3:12. Watch this here, family. Beware, brethren. Beware, sistering, lest there be in any of you what kind of heart? An evil heart of what? Unbelief. Everybody look at me, family. You might as well make a decision today to be fully persuaded. Because if you're not fully persuaded, if you got some unbelief in you, God called unbelief evil. And he said, you're going to be cut off. Now you got heaven made. He ain't talking about not making heaven. He's talking about, I came that you may have life and have life more abundant. He's talking about, somebody say now. Always remember, the person of Jesus is for heaven. Because you got to receive him to be your personal Lord and Savior. But the principles of Jesus are for prosperity. See, he's saying, you're going to be cut off. Why? Because you got unbelief. He says evil. And he said, you better be aware of it. So he's saying, brethren, watch this. Lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief, and departing from the living God. But let's exhort one another daily, where it's called today, lest some of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. Drop down to verse number 19. So we see they could not enter in because of. Now watch this here, family. Everybody look at me. You see that door over there? That you can only go through that door if you believe. You can only go through that door if you fully persuaded. I mean, I wonder how many of us would go through that door. See, that's why the Bible said in verse 19, look at it. So we see they could not what? Enter in because of? If you fully persuaded, you're going to enter in. I can't tell you when and I can't tell you how, but I can tell you it's a done deal. The Bible said they couldn't enter in because of unbelief. Go to Luke chapter number 1, family. Go to Luke chapter number 1. Oh, you got to be fully persuaded. That's what Jesus said. Didn't I tell you? If you believe, you'll see the glory of God. If you believe, you're going to see the miracles, the signs, and the wonders. He said, didn't I tell you? If you don't see it, you might not believe. But watch this here, family. Watch this. He going to confirm his word with signs following. He going to confirm the word. You just keep rolling. And that day going to come, God gonna open up the windows of heaven and pour you out such a blessing, you won't have room enough. They gonna see that your God answered by fire. Watch this. The baby coming, Sarah. He gonna wait till you good and stinking dead, but the baby coming. He gonna wait 4 days. Why did God, why did Jesus wait 4 days? Because the Pharisee believed on the third day that the life was still, the spirit was still in the person. But God always waste that extra day. And I don't like that. God, you ain't got to prove none to them. Go ahead and do it in my life. How many of y'all got what I just said? You ain't got to prove none to them jokers. Most of them ain't going to believe anyway. Go ahead and do it. Somebody say anyway. Make me wait an extra day because of somebody. And a day is as 1,000 years to God. It'd be something. It was just a day. But a day might be 5, 10, 15, 20, 30 years. Because God going to get the glory. Where are we going, fam? Luke chapter number what? Luke chapter number 1. See, God can get upset. He has an attitude when you don't believe. Watch this in Luke chapter number 1. Let's see where I'm going to pick it up at. Let's pick it up in, this is, everybody look at me. This is when the angel came to the prophet, Zechariah. Zechariah and his wife Elizabeth praying for a baby. The angel shows up. See, when you pray, God going to show up. That's why he told Daniel in Daniel chapter 10, verse 12. He said, from the first day you, somebody say the first day. The first day you pray, God released the angels. They on their way. But you got to understand there's three realms. That's the third realm or the third heaven. That's where God is. That's the second heaven. That's where the devil and third of the angels were kicked out. And then the earth that we on. So when you pray, it released from the third heaven. But they're trying to get through the second heaven. And that's where the fight is. Against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness. Now, while the word, the prayer, the manifestation is on the way, you got to endure. You got to persevere. You got to fight the good fight of faith. You can't get weary in well doing. See, you got to, hey, it's, somebody say it's on the way. That's why he said, he told Daniel, said, Daniel, from the first day you prayed, I heard you. God heard you, and he released me to come to give you an answer. But the prince of Persia has held me up, but now Micah had showed up in the fight. Come on now. See, why? Because he don't want you to get the answer, because he know if you get the answer, you're going to help somebody else. All right. So you got to know there's a fight going on, and while there's a fight going on, the Bible says, heaven done all to stand, you got to what?
Stand.
And all of a sudden the answer show up, and you off your spot. Because you didn't gave up. And then now Gabriel, they had to go back and say, God, they weren't there. Because they didn't believe. They ain't standing long enough. I don't care how long it takes. I'm going to stand. Preacher, how long are you going to believe God? Forever. Somebody say forever. So he then came to Zechariah. Zechariah then prayed for it. Now his answer then showed up. Watch Zechariah respond. Verse 13. I'm in Luke chapter number 1, verse 13. But the angel said to him, do not be afraid, Zechariah, for your prayer is what?
Heard.
And your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you should call his name John. And you will have, what's it? And you will have joy and gladness, and many rejoice at his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and should drink neither wine nor a strong drink. Everybody look at me. He said, you should rejoice at his what, family? We just read it. Thank you. You should rejoice at his what? Now everybody look at me. See, God will speak a word to you. Now he spoke a word to Zechariah. 9 months later, here come baby John. Now, what's it? See, that's what happened to me. When I birthed Fresh Start New Beginning, April the 24th of 2011, I was looking for the manifestation. God said, Terry, the ministry is a baby. It took 30 years later before John went into his ministry. So you should, he said, you should rejoice at his birth. Because why? God said, don't despise the days of small beginning. So watch this here, Zunker. So when I birthed it, I'm looking for manifestation. God said, hold on, preach, it's a baby. The baby have to grow up. It was 30 years later before John stepped into his ministry. I'm telling you right now, some of y'all done birthed something. Now you about to eat what you birthed. What you birthed is about to feed you. What you, ooh, that's good. That's a word to myself. I received that word. I received it that. Why? That's why the Bible said, he said, parents, listen to this. He said, your seed, your children gonna answer your enemies. Your seed is, your children gonna answer your enemies at the gate. What you birthed gonna step up for you one day and say, I wish you would put your hands on my mama. Everybody said long time ago. You know, I grew up in the hood. Somebody said long time ago. My mom, Lucia, had 7 kids. She never was married. She had a man. This man used to beat her, Pat. And all we could do was sit there and look. Somebody said one day. One day, them twins who's older than me, a few years older than me, had grew up. That meant every Friday and Saturday, he used to fight my mom. And then all of a sudden, one day, somebody say one day. God is my witness. Watch this, Eric. My brother took a skillet. How many of y'all know them old black skillets? I ain't talking about them things they make today. They might. Cast iron. Harriet, he took that skillet. He hit that man in the back of the head. Bang! And all of a sudden, the game changed. My mom never got another licking or whooping from that day forward. Your seed gonna answer your enemies one day. Roger, I'm telling you the God truth. That he grew up and them other boy, the other twin hit him. Then all of a sudden, he said, these boys didn't grow up. He left my mom and went cross street and started dating another lady, and she shot him and killed him. See, that's what I'm telling you. What you birthed, that's why he said, I just gave somebody a word. You should rejoice at what you have birthed. Because somebody say one day. One day, baby, it's going to grow up. It's going to speak for you. One day, it's going to bless you. That's why he said, you should rejoice at his birth. That's why when Jesus was born, them wise men showed up with incense and frankincense and gold and myrrh and silver. They rejoiced at his birth. Watch this here, family. Watch this here. Verse number 15. And he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He should drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will also be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother womb. All you folks that drink alcohol, tell my pastor, he was just talking about John. He's talking to you too. Quit drinking all that alcohol and all that stuff. Tell me, that's a word for John. That ain't a word for me. The devil is a lie. He's talking to the church right now. Verse 16. And he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God. He will also go before him in the spirit and the power of Elijah. Remember we just read it down about Elijah? Elijah called fire down from heaven. Elijah, you know what I'm saying, the rain came. Watch this here, family. To turn the hearts of the children to the Father and the disobedience to the wisdom of the just to make ready a people prepared for the Lord. And Zechariah said to the angel, how should I know this? For I am an old man. My wife is well advanced in the year. I'm a black woman. I'm a black man. I grew up on this side of the railroad track. I didn't know my daddy. I was molested. You got to put your story in there. Watch this here, family. In verse 19, and the angel said to him, I am who?
Gabriel.
No. Everybody look at me. He ain't just saying I'm Gabriel. He's sitting there with attitude. He said, I'm Gabriel. In other words, what's wrong with you? See, you got to see God's temperament, his disposition. He said, I'm Gabriel. When God give you a word, he's saying, are you serious? He said, I am Gabriel. I stand in the what, family? Presence of God and was sent to speak to you and to bring you this what?
Amen.
But behold, see? The word behold means see? You will be mute and not able to speak until the day these things take place because you did not
believe my words,
which will be fulfilled in their what? Because when God speaks, it's a seed. Everybody look at me. He had an attitude. God has an attitude when you have unbelief.
Come on now.
He said, I'm Gabriel. I told you.
Yes.
Didn't I tell you? How I know this going to happen? Because I told you. That's how you know it going to happen. See, God has an attitude when you don't believe him. And he should have an attitude. See, there's no reason God done did too many things in our lives for us not to believe him. See, and the same way that Gabriel is talking to Zechariah is the same way God talking to you. Go to John, go to Numbers chapter 14. He said, I'm Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God. I was sent to speak to you. I ain't come on my own. Angels are messengers. Come on now. They are sent by God, baby, to tell you what God said. Yes, but then, watch here. And then the next few verses, he show up to Mary's house. But watch Mary respond. Be it done unto me according to thy word. How many be it done unto me according to thy word? People are up in here. See? He had an attitude. And that's what I'm showing you. If Gabriel had an attitude, can you imagine God's attitude? He said, are you serious, bro? See, if he was in today's modern term, he wouldn't say, I am Gabriel. He said, he talked like, man, what's wrong with you? I ain't got time to be coming out here and just tell you what God said, just to be playing game. You need to get your tail in order. He talked bad to you. But remember, he's an angel. So he had to be in God's presence. He got to be holy. Holy, holy, holy. That's why he got all, ain't no flesh in him. Because it was up to me. I said, man, something wrong with you. I talk bad to you. Shut your mouth for 9 months. Thank God he sent Gabriel. All throughout the Bible, God has the same attitude. Y'all remember Moses? Moses said, God, the people are complaining because they want water. So the Bible said Moses took a rod and struck the rock, and what flowed? Water. But the Bible said they kept complaining. And God said, Moses, this time I want for you to speak to the rock because the power was in our mouth. So the Bible said Moses was angry and took the rod and struck it. He said, you old Moses, see, you can talk bad to people and still be in the spirit. Moses said, you ungrateful, unappreciated. You know how to use your words. You know how to use your words right. You can get your point across. Moses struck that rock. Nothing happened because God told him to speak it. The Bible said he spoke it. He struck it a second time. Bang, there go water flowing from it. Moses was angry with them because God had did all them signs and wonders and they still didn't believe. See, and because Moses, the Bible said, Moses, because you didn't make me holy before the people, you're going to see the promised land, but you're not going to go in. Why? Because you didn't believe me. And that's one of the biggest things in the scripture for me. If Moses didn't go in, you know we ain't going in with unbelief. Because I'm still talking. God said, Terry, Moses been with me for 1,000 years. Will you leave Moses good? Because God, you shouldn't let Moses come in. Because you know Moses had a 2 million people church and all of them out there complaining. See? Amen. See, but God didn't let Moses in because Moses didn't do what he told him to do. So I look it up, I pick it up in verse number, Numbers what? 14. The same thing. Somebody say the same thing. Watch this here, family. Watch this here. Pick it up in verse number 8. Look what Caleb said. If the Lord delights in us, then he will bring us into the land and give it to us. A land that flows with milk and honey. Only do not rebel. That word rebellion. Do not rebel against the Lord, nor fear the people of the land. For they are bread. They are our bread. And their protection has departed from them. And the Lord is what, family? The Lord is what? Do not fear them. And all the congregation said to stone them with stone. Now the glory of the Lord appeared in the tabernacle of meeting before all the children of Israel. Then the Lord said to Moses, how long would these people do what, family? Would do what? Reject me. How long would they not do what? Believe who? Believe me. With all the signs and wonders and miracles which I perform among them. He said, how long? Everybody say, how long?
How long?
How long? How long is it going to take for you to be fully persuaded? Any fully persuaded people in the house today? How long is it going to take for you to be fully persuaded? See, how long is it going to take for you to be fully persuaded? Put my scripture up on Romans chapter number 4. We'll close with this here. How long is it going to take? Romans chapter 4, verse 17. How long is it going to take in the Message Bible? I want for y'all to see. We're going to finish with that. How long are you going to reject God? Are you going to despise him? Everybody look at me. They want to stone Joshua and Caleb because they can't see God. But let me tell you something. When you reject his vessel, when you reject his word, you reject him. See? He said, how long are you going to... God hates unbelief. But now, being fully persuaded, all of it come down to Abraham. We're going to read his story out of the Message Bible, and God going to give us nuggets. He's going to give us secrets. He's going to give us insight into Abraham's story. And remember, the Bible said these things were written for our learning, for our instruction, that we through patience, endurance, come to Scripture, we might have hope. And he's no respected person. So we're going to look at Abraham's story, and then you see where you are, and then you should be at a place of being fully persuaded. So the Bible says we call Abraham father, not because he got God's attention by living like a saint. How many of y'all know that Abraham lied? It's Sarah. Before we go in there, you tell them folks you my sister now. Because you good looking. These folks, that king going to want you, girl. So he wasn't acting like a... So that tell me you can be fully persuaded and not act like a... That's a good word for somebody. See, so we call Abraham father, not because he got God's attention by acting like a saint, but because God made something out of Abraham. Put your name in there, Terry. Because he made something out of Abraham when he was a
nobody.
God ain't looking for somebody. God's are looking for
nobody.
And when you say, Pastor, ain't nothing, I don't have anything, you know what I'm saying? I don't know how God can you perfect. It's that joke coming down, you know, I got all these degrees, my family this here and that, I got all this in the money. Baby, God can't use you. God going to humble you first.
All right.
Ask Nebuchadnezzar. I done built this kingdom, and God said, this day, the kingdom is snatched from your hand. Not because he got God's attention by acting like a saint, because God made something out of Abraham when he was a nobody. Isn't that what we always read in the Scripture? God saying to Abraham, I set you up. Somebody say it's a setup. Family, you don't know when God speaks to you, baby, it's a pure setup.
Right now.
He said, I set you up. Everybody say favor.
Favor.
Somebody say favor ain't fair.
Favor.
When God speaks to you, he just gave you favor.
Yes.
It ain't got nothing to do with how you look.
Right.
Amen. I set you up as father of many people. He was first named what, family? Father. He was first named what? Father, then he became a what? Everybody look at me. The first thing God going to do is name you, then you're going to become it.
All right.
Are you with me? He was first named Father, then he became a father because he dared to trust God to do what God only can do. Everybody look at me. When God spoke to me 19 years ago in April, come on, he said, Terry, fresh start, new beginning. I want a fresh start, new beginning. Now I am one. So called God first named you, then you what? Okay, fam, watch this. The Bible says, as it is in the natural, so it is in the spirit. When do you normally name your child? When they what? Okay, before they come. Okay, we look at Zechariah. He said, Zechariah, you should name him John. Before Jesus came, you should name, told Mary, and the husband, what's the husband's name?
Joseph.
You should name him Jesus. See, before Solomon came, he told David and Bathsheba, you should call him Solomon. See, before Ishmael came, he told him, you should name him. Ishmael was the first name that God named. You should call him Ishmael. Told Sarah, Abraham, and Isaac, when he come, you should name him Isaac. So God named you before you are born. But when you born, you name your... Quit calling all your baby, all these Shaquiquas and all these crazy names. Now, Shaquiqua, Shanae, I ain't got no problem with you. That stuff ain't got no spiritual implication to it, no power to it, because the power is in the... Hey, folks call, babe, what that mean? Well, you know, I took that African name, put it with that Brazilian name. Babe, you got a bunch of mess. Oh, just a prophetic word right here. Some of y'all need to go rename y'all baby. Some of y'all need to rename yourself. Everybody say true story.
True story.
You know I watch sports. It's my way of relaxing. I ain't relaxed last night because my team lost, but no story. Pray for me, Pat. Watch this here. There's a guard in the NBA. His name is Isaiah Thomas. He played for the Boston Celtics. How many of y'all know him? Isaiah is about 5'8 or something. Going to the All-Star game this year. His mother named him after Hall of Famer Isaiah Thomas. See, you got to understand, names are prophetic. And the Bible says, this is how the Jewish culture would do it. Jewish culture, they'll wait till they're 8 days old and then they name the baby. But in the, you can name before or you can wait till they're 8 days. But you tell people, quit naming your babies all this foolishness. Because the Bible said he was first named Abraham, then he became it. You're going to become whatever your name is. See, if somebody, like I grew up in a neighborhood, we had Killer Blue. Guess what Killer ended up doing? Amen. We had all these nicknames, and you're going to become whatever your name. Don't let nobody call you out of your name. You're a child of God. When you got born again, God said, you're a child of God now. You are a Christian. You are a Christian. See, that's why the Bible says he was first named Abraham, then he became the father, and then became a father because he dared to trust God to do what only God could do, raise the dead to what, family? Life. With the word, make something out of. You got to understand, words are things. When you speak, he said, faith is the substance of things. Hope for it's the evidence of things not seen. You got to know words are things. When you speak something, I'm spitting up in here, boy. Let me get up here. Because I want for y'all to get this thing. Words are things. Death and life is in the power of the. See, you got to know when every time you see me, you're saying fresh start, new beginning. Yeah, I'm becoming what God spoke to me. See, I didn't come up with that name. See, you got to know words are things. So the Bible said, with the word, watch this, to do, dare to trust God, only God can do right dead like, with the word, make something out of what? Then let me tell you something, baby. When God going to do something in your life, all he going to do is give you a
word.
All he going to give you, do and that word going to become a thing. That's all he going to do. Abraham, all God gave Abraham was a word. All he gave Zechariah was a
word.
All he gave David was a
word.
David, you're going to be the next what?
King.
King. All he gave Noah was a
word.
The Bible says he sent his word. All he's going to give you is a
word.
If you receive that word going to become a
thing.
Y'all got it.
All right.
To do only God can do, raise the dead to life. What a word. See, let me tell you something, family. You know what you come here today for?
A word.
That's what you come here. You ain't come to see what Pastor Terry had on, how Sister Linda gonna dress. If you did, you came for the wrong reason. Amen. With the word, what's it? Trust God, do only God can do. Raise the dead to life. With a word, make some out of nothing. When everything was what? When everything was what? Hopeless, Abraham believed anyway. That's being fully persuaded. Let me tell you something, fully persuaded, baby. When everything don't look like it, don't supposed to look like, I believe anyway. Because I got a word. The Bible said when everything was hopeless, he believed. See, that's where people miss it at, right there. See, the Bible said when everything was hopeless, he believed anyway. Pastor, why are you still believing? I got a word. Let me ask you a question. Anybody got a word up in here?
Hallelujah.
When everything looks hopeless, you're going to believe anyway. Watch this. When everything was hopeless, he believed anyway, deciding. See, it's a decision. Remember I said before you, life and death, blessings, cursing. This day, choose life that you and your sin. Everything in life come down to making a decision. He decided to do what? Deciding, watch this here, family, deciding to do what? Watch it. Deciding to live not on the basis of what he saw that he could not do, but on what God said, that's the problem. Most folks don't have the word. Deciding, watch this here, to live not on the basis of what he saw he could not do, but what on God said he would do. And so he was made the father of what? a multitude of people. God himself said, fresh start, new. You're going to have a big family. Whatever God said to you, that's what you need to be saying. Go to the next one. Watch this here, family. Watch this here. Abraham did not focus on his own impotency and say it is hopeless. It is what? I don't care how bad it looked. Don't you speak nothing out your mouth that don't lie what God didn't say. See, that's why I said Abraham did not focus on impotence and say, it is hopeless. It'll never happen. Man, shut up. The only somebody could talk is people God ain't spoke to. Baby, if God just said something to you, shut up. He didn't say it is hopeless. This 100-year-old body could never father a child. Nor did he survey Sarah's decades of infertility and give up. He did not tiptoe around the promise of God, asking cautiously, skip. You think it's going to happen? How much longer it's going to take? Do you think really God going to do something for you? You 80-some years old. You know how folk tiptoe up and you said, you think God going to do? Man, get up out of my, I know he going to do it. See, they already know you're a believer, so they try to tiptoe up to you. How much longer are you going to think? I don't know how much longer, but I know it's a done deal. See, he didn't, watch this here, family, he didn't tiptoe around God's promises, asking, come on, cautiously skeptical questions. That's how I know whether or not you believe. I listen to your questions. See, he plunged. See, I grew up in the swimming pool. We used to dive off the diving board. The Bible said he plunged, he dove. What did he plunge? He dove into the promise of God and came up strong. Watch this here, family. Ready for God. Sure that God will make good on what he said. That's why it is said Abraham would declare a fit before God by trusting God to set him right. But here's the part I like. But it's not. Come on, everybody read that. But it's not just for. It ain't just for Abraham. Remember, these things was written for our learning. It ain't just for what? Abraham. It ain't just for Abraham, but it's also for us. The same thing gets said about us when we are fully persuaded that what God promised, he's able to perform. Watch this. It ain't just for Abraham, but it's also for us. The same thing gets said about us when we embrace and believe. When we embrace and believe. The same thing gets said about us when we embrace and believe. The same thing gets said about us when we embrace and believe. The one who brought Jesus back to life when the conditions, watch this here, family, was equally hopeless. Now, everybody look at me. I'm closing right now. God going to make, when he give you a word, he going to confirm it with signs following. And he going to make sure, watch this here. He going to make sure it's dead before he bring it to life. He waited for Abraham to turn 99. I was born at 100. Sarah was 90. He waited to Lazarus 4 days. He let Jesus be in the grave for 3 days. The Bible said when it was equally hopeless, when the condition was equally hopeless for Jesus. Remember how they laughed when Jesus was in the grave, talking about he's finished? Baby. Let me tell you something. When you got a word from God, that word is planted. It's not buried. That's the difference between being planted and buried. See, you bury the dead. But the Bible said when God plant a seed in you, it's a harvest attached to that. Because that's why he said it's seed time harvest. But God going to wait till, he going to wait till equally hopeless. God go, why? Because he want to make sure you are fully, that what he promised you, he's able to perform. I'm telling you right now, family. See, I don't care. The worse it look, the more you praise him. Because when it's all over, they're going to come and say, you told me. Yeah, because he told me. I told you because he what? I don't know what I can do for y'all. We can go home now. What I just said, we can do what? We can go home now. If you ain't fully persuaded now, somebody said something wrong with you. Come on, every head bowed, every eye closed. Father, in the name of Jesus, nobody moving except those authorized to do so. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word. Your word should not return you void. It shall, it must, it will accomplish what you set it out to do. Now, Father, it's our desire. We make a decision now. Somebody say now. To be fully persuaded that what you promised us, you're able to perform. When we was nobody, you chose to make us out of somebody. All you did was give us a word. The word is imperishable, indestructible, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. Your word should not return you void. It shall, it must, it will accomplish what you set it out to do. We receive it by faith in the name of Jesus. Every head bowed, every eye closed, nobody moving. Four invitations. Number one is for anyone who would like to receive Jesus Christ, their personal Lord and Savior. Invitation number two, if you're in here, you're not sure whether or not you're born again. We got trained counselors who will take you line upon line to make sure of your salvation. Invitation number three is to be baptized with the Holy Spirit, with the evidence of speaking with other tongues. And invitation number four is for church membership. If you'd like to respond to one of those invitations, raise your hands now where the man of God can see it. Okay, everybody look up. Okay. Every head bowed. Okay. If you raise your hand, stand to your feet. Amen. Amen. I want for you to get all your belongings together. I'm going to have you come stand before me. Amen. We're going to pray with you and for you. Everybody, you can look up, family. You can look up. If anybody else want to join the woman of God, come on, step through here. Watch your step there. Amen. Come on, give it up for the woman of God as she comes. Woman of God, I'm going to pray with you and for you. We're going to believe God for whatever you believe in God for. I want you to raise one hand to the heaven. That's where your help come from. Family, extend your hand toward the woman of God. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the woman of God who came forth, who responded to your voice. I believe, Lord God, when she get with the counselor, she'll receive what she believed in you for. I believe this is the best day of the rest of her life. We thank you as we put our faith in agreement with her faith. We call it done in the name of Jesus. Okay, you can put your hand down. Congratulations. Go with the man of God. Amen. Come on, give it up. Let me tell you something, family. That scripture I just gave you, Romans chapter 4, verse through 25, the message, but you need to go eat that up. Amen. If he didn't do it for Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, then came Joseph, then came Moses, then came the prophet Samuel, all the other prophets, David, Matthew's on. You got to do this thing by faith. You got to be fully persuaded. Come on now. Everybody about it is fully persuaded. What God promised them, this is what you need. You need your own word. If you go read the story, it's in the book of John chapter number 4, that the Samaritan told the woman of God, said, the Bible says some of them believed on Jesus because of her word. But the Bible said Jesus stayed 2 days later and spoke to him himself. Somebody say himself. They went back to the woman and said, we don't believe because of your word. We heard him for you need to hear God for yourself. And when you hear God for yourself, you're fully persuaded what God promised you he's able to perform.